Hello, I'm Sarospa, and today I'll be your humble guide through Final Fantasy IV. When we last left off, we had abandoned the main quest to save the world at the last minute in order to do all the side quest stuff, as is custom. So we're here in the land of the summoned monsters, and I decided to look up how to get those damn chests. It's surprisingly simple, but also pretty well hidden, so I guess it's understandable that I didn't find it after all that time. If I can properly navigate these teleporters. But no. The way to get there is this oddly highlighted square right here. It'll just lead us straight there. And that's it. I guess I just got thrown off because it's on the top floor of the area, which I didn't really think to look there. So that's pretty tricky of them. Not that the treasure is all that exciting for all those years of not knowing what was there, but that's the way it goes. So then we've got this kind of quick exit out. Just convenient, because we don't need to be here no more. What's this? I don't think there's anything here. That's weird. So there are a couple other places that I want to visit. Wait, what? We can't land on this brownish stuff. Wait, can we land here? We can. That's weird, I didn't know that. There's no reason whatsoever why you'd want to, but you know, that's kind of neat. There's a lot of random places you can land that don't really mean anything, and I guess it does kind of make the place feel more organic and natural. Oh, they're in fine health. So there are two major locations that we're gonna want to visit. I don't know if I'd count this as major. This is actually a minor location. So we got a minor location and a major location to visit. Oh no. I actually don't know how bad of a threat Malbros are in this game, but I have bad memories of Malbros. I believe the first game that I encountered them in was Final Fantasy VII. No, 8. Final Fantasy 8. And if you encounter a Malbro in Final Fantasy 8, unless you've very carefully prepared your party, you can wipe without getting a single turn. Malbros are nasty. And there's a lot of other games where they are similarly dangerous. I don't know about this one. I don't think they are. But they tend to put all kinds of bad status effects on you, and I just don't want to deal with that. Although I don't know if I've ever seen them here, in Final Fantasy IV. Apparently, they're slow even when they get the jump on me. So we're here to kind of poke around and. Wait, there's no like. Huh. Okay. Oh, what the heck. Let's see if we can kill these things. Okay. He's a frog now. So that's cool. Admittedly, it's not as bad as they'd get later, where they'd hit you with, the entire party with bad breath. That's terrible. Frog and confusion kind of, the frog effect kind of weakens the effect of it a little bit. Not nullify, I guess. Whoa! Holy crap! So, hold on a second. He's simultaneously a frog, tiny, and a pig, and silent, and blind. That's impressive. I don't think that really makes any sense. So that was a thing. Weird. The encounter rate is getting on my nerves. Just want to explore a cave. Just want to chill out. Enjoy the soundtrack. You know, you don't have to listen to the high energy battle music all the time. Just, you know, this is nice. Just kick back. Listen to the sound of being in a cave. Yes. This place is actually a lot more labyrinthine than I remember. So, this is going to be fun. What the f- I didn't take that treasure. Or that one. That's weird. Forgot to put float back on. This is going to be a little annoying. We're gonna run out of magic at this rate. Well, screw it. There's a save point right here. I hope we keep float after going to sleep. It's kind of an odd place to put a save point, actually. I mean, it's not actually very deep into the dungeon. Technically, we're on the first floor. This better be worth it. Is it worth it? I don't know. Probably if I got some good arrows it would be, but I haven't been really using Rosa for offense. Or Carlos. I don't really know if there's much point in doing so. I mean, as far as damage goes, I don't think the arrows really keep up. Oh, a cabin. Well, there you go. Okay, so we gotta be thorough and get all the treasure. So, this is going to be, interesting. I probably actually should have visited this cave earlier. I think I'm going to... Oh, you... Okay, then. It only affected one person, so there you go. You know, being a toad lady has got to be even worse than being a cat lady. Wow, that was really self-defeating. I have a virus. Well, she's pretty dead. Now to kill some toads. And I really didn't go into this cave with much commentary in mind. I really shouldn't be sticking around on these encounters for very long. I guess one good reason to fight in these areas is that we really gotta get the levels going here. Because we need to be strong for the final boss. It's really what we've got to deal with here. What if we just virus the whole party? That might be fun. I don't really use a multi-target virus that often. I guess it's just because it's, you know, it's more concentrated damage. But on the other hand, I mean, it inflicts sap on everybody. Brzk. Look out for their brzk. I don't want to mess with that. He's dead anyway. I kinda wish we could see how much of an effect the sap is having. One of the frustrating things about viruses, you know they're losing hit points, but you just can't see it. You don't even get like little pop-up damage numbers. So that kind of sucks. It's kind of hard to judge the effectiveness of it without that. But such is the way of the old school RPG, is the primitive interface. Oh, come on. This is getting out of hand. Eventually, you just gotta say, enough's enough, you know? Oh, this is gonna be funny. Six of them. Come on, this isn't a fight, this is a comedy routine. I don't even know if they have any offense other than just turning everybody into toads. And they don't seem to be having much success with that route anyway. I have a virus. That seemed to work before. I don't even know, like, how much damage the toads can take. Maybe I should be focusing on them. Really not having much luck here. He got triple toaded. Bye-bye now. Maybe we should virus the toads all at once and see what happens. Let's see. Yeah, heal's freaking expensive. I don't get it. It's only a universal cure-all for every single status effect in the game. What's the big deal? Virus. At least they're durable enough to take that. We know that much. So what is up with these toad enemies? Like, I'm trying to think of like what the plan is here, because like turning you into a toad isn't going to kill you, and they don't really come alongside any other enemies. They don't like group together with something that could actually deal damage. So is it just kind of meant to screw with you? I don't get it. Oh, come on. The six toad arrangement isn't even a special encounter. I guess it's just meant to annoy you by having you being stuck as a toad. And I haven't forgotten to put float on. I'm just trying to save MP if I can. Ah, we made it to the bottom. There's just three of these things, we may as well take them out. I'm sort of semi-hoping that we're not gonna have any huge grinding sessions before the final boss, but I am not getting my hopes up for that. Because we are... really don't have that much time left until we're gonna be digging into the ultimate final super dungeon. And in the intervening time, we're somehow gonna have to grow by like 10, 15 levels. So that's gonna be something. Boop. Jeez, you take a lot of damage, Edge. Be more ninja-y. Dodge it. Jesus. Oh, that was easy. So yeah, this is where Yang ended up after he was tossed off the boat. This is why I should have visited sooner, is because I could have come here and seen him. Hey! It was... hey! It's not fair, that wasn't even marked. But anyway, I'm gonna have to start all over. Let's make this quick. I can do it. Come on. But yeah, you could have gone here and actually seen him while he was being cared for by the sylphs. Pretty much. No. I'm getting completely thrown off. That wasn't he. We saw him after he got thrown off. Didn't I put the float on back on? Forgot again. No, I have to keep the actual order of events in the story in my mind. But no, he got thrown off the boat, and then we rejoined up with him in Baron. And then he got blowed up in the super cannon. Super duper ultra cannon. And then the sylphs picked him up. I don't know how you survive being inside a room that explodes, but I don't know, I guess he's just got, you know, diamond hard abs. So that helps, I guess. Jeez. Place is a mess. I'm completely lost here. Okay, so down this way and got it. We gotta get back up to the first floor somehow. Dealing with three of these things. Considering the cavalcade of interesting status effects that Cecil got, we might actually be in legitimate trouble if they actually did hit a lot of people with that. Treasure! Probably it's not even worth the effort to get all this stuff, but you know, whatever. I can kill ghosts. That can get me some experience points. I don't know. Let's see. So I don't want to forget any side quest material. I have a feeling that I'm probably going to, though, get some stuff. But you do what you can. But from here, so there is the talk of the true king of the monsters, who is Bahamut, and who we are going to be paying a visit to. That's probably going to be last on last on our itinerary for today. This is back towards the sylph's house. How do I get over to the... on? I have no idea where I'm going. This is what I should just not... I should get it, go into these with a map. I could start of the game really confident, because, like, that's the part of the game you freaking play 1,000 times, you know? But this is the part of the game I'm less familiar with. I have come into it woefully underprepared. But I didn't remember this place being such a labyrinth. Oops, I wanted to heal Rydia. So freaking confusing. What's this? Oh no. No, no, no. No more toads. I've had enough of your toad shit. No, because this is a dead end. Right? So then... back, cast float again. Was this really necessary, the float thing? Could they have not just let me have it till I, till I got to the world map at least? I mean, there's nothing really gained from having to do this except just to waste my time. Oh my god, they actually got someone. Alright, alright, alright. Heal. Heal. And we're off. Let's look here. No more. Let's load again. Obviously, there's just one path I'm not seeing. So we entered from here, right? That leads towards the entrance, and I think this just leads towards a chest, so it's a dead end, right? Yeah. Okay, so then we're leaving this way, and there's got to be some other route we can take. Yeah, this is wasting a lot of time. Float again. What the? What did I? Okay, float and then. So that's the exit, right? I think. Freaking no. This place is confusing as hell. Come on, I've had enough of your toad shit. I thought this would be just kind of a quick one and done. And I had to complicate things. Have I been this way? No, I haven't. The heck is that? I may have I may have underestimated the majorness of this dungeon. Misunderestimated. Yeah. Apparently I can't talk today. Of course I can't talk any day, but that's just what you gotta deal with. This place is a frickin' magic sponge. To get frickin' anywhere, we gotta spend all this magic. It's a wall of chests blocking the way. God damn it! This game is just so frickin' excessive with all of the back attacks and all that. It's absurd. It's unnecessary. Out of here. What is up with this? What's that? Where does it go? I have no idea. Have I ever gone there before? Obviously, in the future, I should do a little bit of pre-recording prep. It's the responsible thing to do. Jesus. Of course, a lot of the time wasted around here is just the sheer volume of encounters, and there's not much I can do about that. Alright, let's turn them back from being tiny toad pigs. Should have just rested at the safe spot again, but whatever. I hardly even use ethers anyway. Whoa. The heck? That's different. I may have never been here before. Excited. I have no idea where we're going. Probably gonna be disappointed by the result, but... Ah, what the heck. Let's kill these guys. Like I said, we do need a little bit of XP, at least. Set me on fire, will ya? Take that. And that. Aha. Alright, let's go. The game and its weird dead-end secret passageways. What's this? Ah, shit. This whole place is covered with, deadly green things. Jeez. Every single one of these chests is gonna be filled with monsters, isn't it? This is gonna be fun, I can tell. Take these things out, these Marlboro things, because they're bad for us. Got punched by a frog. Oh boy, this is gonna be an adventure. Fast. Holy fuck. I can still use items as a frog, I suppose. Okay, you are going away now. Fuck's sake. What's that? Sounds like something Edge could equip. Bring myself to use an elixir. Just eat up a few of these things. Slept at the frickin' save spot. Whatever. I've got a lot of money now, so I can always buy back more of them. Heal. You just have to waste so much magic in this dungeon. I swear. I guess that was kind of a waste. Okay. Now, monsters. Monsters, yep. Six ghosts. See if we can't do something to take these guys out in short order. She's running low on magic too. Tired of your shit, ghosts. If they get healed from this, I'm gonna be pissed. Titan. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Hey, an elixir. What do you know? Whoops. Boop. 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 Monsters! Screw you. Screw you and your status effect shit. Okay. Jesus. Well, nobody died. This is good experience points. What's an Avenger? Better? I can't use it. To equip? What does that mean? He doesn't get that error message from other ones. Is that a bug? Okay, what about Kane? Can Kane equip it? No? Gridia? No, what about Edge? Whoops. What about Edge, who is a toad? Can he equip it? What's going on here? Okay, I'm gonna make a mental note to investigate that later. Cause that seems like some kind of bug. Well, maybe we can throw it at the final boss. Titan. Yeah, I know, I'm using up all her magic. Seeing as I've given up on my my firm stance against items, I may as well just have her down some ethers as well. So I think we can probably still finish this up, do a little bit of side stuff, and still have time to poke our head at least into Bahamut's dungeon. So I think we're still fine as far as making progress, you know. Stuff. Spread the love a little bit. There we go. That's fine. Monsters. Do we really need 6 of these? Titan. These encounters would take forever without this guy. May as well just wait till she finishes casting the spell, because it seems to be pretty effective. Stop setting Rydia on fire. Alright, there you go. I'm so glad that takes them out. Hey! Life 2! Only took us like frickin' 75% of the game to get it. More than that, probably. Whoa! Centipedes. not very strong centipedes. Is this really worthy of being a box encounter? I'm gonna go ahead and say not worthy. Oh, and our reward is just some egg. Okay. Gonna go through here and see if there's any more treasure, and then we are leaving. I'm sick of this place. Really sick of this place. Make this next part quick. And yeah, I might have left behind some treasure at the Sylvan Cave. At this point, I really don't care that much. Okay, so for this next thing, this is something that is actually fairly straightforward if you know what you are doing. And I do know what I'm doing, kind of. We have, first of all, a doohickey, it's a technical term, on our other airship, if I can find it, that lets us pick up the hovercraft. Around here. I left it, we can't pick it up with this one, right? No, it just tries to land on it. Excellent plan. What's this? I don't know. You kind of wonder about all these kind of unimportant looking alcoves that can only be reached by airship. I almost wonder, is there something to them? I don't think that there is. I've known the ins and outs of this game for a long time, and there's not some things I missed, but in general, I kind of have a grasp on what's interesting and what's not. Where did we put that thing? Where did we put the airship? Someone tell me. It's around here somewhere. We're just gonna have to comb the world for it. Was it next to the hole? No, I would have seen it. Think. Because I remember it was last episode, it was next to the lunar whale. And that's weird. I picked it up, and I parked it next to, where we put this ship, because I thought we needed to take this one with us, maybe. So obviously it can't be that obscure a place, because, it's just right here next to Mysidia. It's like, frickin' two screens away from, I guess that's not really fair, because everything in this game is it's like two screens away by airship. But anyway, now to get some shit done. So, we gotta do is, now we gotta find that little chain of islands. Yeah, here we are. So, is this a chocobo forest? Huh. Okay, it's not a chocobo forest. So this is a land of tiny people. Teeny tiny people. What? Okay. That's okay, We're in this now. Okay. That's interesting. Someone obviously had fun with these dances. What's that? There's just like an unattended stairs. It's not even like connected to anything really. It's just... These buildings are weird. Oh well. Let's see if there's anything notable here. Silver sword. You know, we need to sell some crap, actually. I'm not using arrows anymore, so, sell a quantity of 10. Let's just sell all these frickin' arrows. Can I only sell them 10 at a time? Need these. I don't think we need these. Actually, we should keep those. Because we can throw them. Don't need this, don't need this. I think that should do it. You know, I don't think it's really worth bothering with. The fact that a wrench is for sale probably is a sign that this is kind of beneath us at this point in the game. We're not really here for the town, as you might have guessed by the fact that we brought the hovercraft. We're here visit this cave. Also, that wasn't north. So we picked this little item up in the Land of Summoned Monsters. And this is what we need it for. It's kind of an unassuming item, although if you follow the Final Fantasy games, you might know that the rat tail is kind of an important item. So what are we gonna do with this adamantine ore? Well, if you remember back when we first started poking around in the underground, we ran across this smith, right? So we want to find him again. I always have trouble finding the islands. I've gone in a circle. I guess it's very easy to go in circles in this game. I need like landmarks that I can remember. I'm really terrible at finding my way around places. Here we are. So it's east of the Tower of Babel, so that's good to remember. Okay, so both airships are good, so I was wrong about needing a particular one. Oh, come on! That was literally the only square I had to cover in order to get here. I guess I didn't have to, but where I parked, I did. It's pretty freaking expensive. Something you throw and don't get back. Aha! All right. This guy looks so generic. Wow, that was frickin' quick. So yeah, if you poke around the world a bit, you can get the legendary sword Excalibur. So that's pretty frickin' sweet. Let's organize this shit. With that done, I think that... Well, let me think. Any other summons we're missing? Oh, yeah, okay. I almost forgot. One more place we need to stop before we go back to the moon. Let's do this. It's time to go back to Baron for the last time. Because there's someone we need to meet here. I believe I tried this once way earlier, and it was too early, but now is most certainly the time. Okay, so we gotta take out Odin. I don't know if I'm really gonna use Odin much. But gotta collect the whole set, I guess. Let's keep people alive. Boom. I wonder how much hit points he has. Usually there's kind of a classic trope about Odin where you have to fight him within a certain time limit. I don't know if that's the case here. There's no timer, but he might just frickin' kill us. Yeah, kinda like that. If I can keep everyone alive just long enough. Oh, come on. Am I really not strong enough? Okay, how about... They get all the treasure? God fucking damn it. Okay. That is entirely on me. Shit. The one time that I neglect to save in a timely manner. Wow, okay. That's annoying. So. Really running down the clock right now. I might go back and get the Sylvan Cave stuff off camera. It's not a big deal. It's just freaking obnoxious. But let's re-get Excalibur. That was entirely my own stupid fault. I should have saved before our major boss fight, but I guess I was I was overconfident and did not expect to get killed by Odin. That was freaking dumb. So we get this thing. Luckily, this side quest can be taken care of really quickly. If you know what you're doing, and I do. So then we go back. Try and freaking find it. Okay, so then we go this way. So I propose that, instead of banging my head against Odin, I think I will come back once I have learned Lightning 3. Which I think would increase our chances of success quite a bit. So, mental note, save before doing anything incredibly dangerous. That will be our obvious advice of the day. All the crap that I sold before is back in my inventory. Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit of off-camera work restoring all the crap that I lost in the last 15 minutes or so. But that's fine. You're not missing anything. Or you saw it. And that's the important thing. So, we've been putting this off long enough. It's time to go to the frickin' moon. Leaving the Earth. Won't be back. That you'll see at least, anyway. Let's see. I would kind of also like to visit this place. I didn't mean to land there. How do you freaking get here anyway? No, no, wait. Is this the wrong? That's the we already were there. Here's the, man, this place is tiny. Is this it? Yeah, I think this is it. Okay. I don't know why I confused those two places. I had a weird feeling that there were, like, two different entrances to it. Something. I don't know. I'm misremembering things from playing this game like ages ago. I guess we will be back on the Earth on camera in order to take out Odin. So, this is the race which Aiming Ways descended from. I freaking walk fast too. They're supposedly moon rabbits, although they never really looked much like rabbits to me. There's not really much here, except that you just kind of learn of the origin of, Aiming Way. Although, I could have sworn there was an item shop here, actually. Guess I was just misremembering because I figured there had to be some purpose to visit here. But no, it's just kind of an Easter egg, really. But the place that we're really interested in, and I can promise you, we're not gonna beat Bahamut anytime right away. But we can at least poke our heads in and maybe make a little bit of progress. This cave here. Later translations called this area the Lair of the Father, which I like that a lot better. A lot of the translations in the original game are kind of literal-minded, I guess. There's a tunnel there. But I kind of tend to prefer the later translations, with a few exceptions. Oh, come on. But, there is one particular, rather unforgiving gimmick in, in this dungeon. Oh yeah, he already had a samurai shield. That's kind of a pointless treasure. Well, so yeah, this one has a pretty rough gimmick to it that you will see fairly shortly here. Some treasure lying around too. This is all the armor that Kane already had. Deep breath. Oops. Scary. All right, let's do this. Yeah, this thing has random hidden boss fights. These don't work like regular encounters. If, Jesus Christ. Right. If you run away from them, and I believe you can run away from them, then you won't be able to get past. I think you get sent back a square. We just use a life on him. Maybe he won't get hit. So yeah, the behemoth hits like a freaking truck. And really the best way to go about it is just to blink the fuck out of your characters. Or that kind of thing happens. And we'll see how this fight goes over. I have my doubts that this is going to work very well. But, you know, we'll see. Does anything really work against this guy in terms of magic? Can we stop him? I think we might be able to. Shit. Okay, we need to blink Rosa badly. See, so one day, you gotta learn life. I think he's gonna learn life. Holy shit, we fucking killed a behemoth. Wait, didn't... Oh no, cause... Yeah. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're going to vacate the premises. Because once you kill a behemoth, it's dead for good, I think. I believe that in total there are three. So if we can take these guys out one at a time, we will clear the path to Bahamut. I think that I really had a lot of trouble getting past the behemoths for a long time, and I think it's just because I didn't know to use Blink. But once you do, it actually eases the fight considerably. The samurai gear. I wonder, is Kane a samurai? No, the Dragoon isn't the same thing as a samurai. So why does he get all this samurai gear? Holy shit! What the fuck are giant robots doing here? And yeah, I know. I'm completely skipping just every single encounter in here. But I don't feel that guilty about it. Some things you just gotta do. So, let's see, this is a fairly deep cave, I think. Of course, traveling one third of the way through the cave and killing a behemoth, and then two thirds of the way through the cave, killing a behemoth, and then three thirds of the way through the cave and killing a behemoth, is gonna get a little old after a while. But, you know, it's the safest way to deal with this by far. Okay, so Blink Rosa. By all means, hit Kane. He can take it. I'm so glad that Edge can image himself. Having one party member covered without having to spend Rose's turn is really eases the difficulty of keeping everyone covered. Okay, so we're in a good place right now. Did I try casting Stop on him? I could have sworn I did. Ah, there he goes. That actually went really smoothly. I think I'm gonna risk going for one more. And then, thinking if there's time to go for it, I have technically already gone over an hour here, I believe. Please don't let that be another one. Pretty sure there's only three. Jesus Christ. This is costing me money here. But I really don't feel like dealing with the random encounters right now. This might turn out to be a good training spot, I don't know. I should actually look up, like, what are good grinding spots. Alright, let's do this. As long as we can keep Rosa under evasion, I think that we should be in a pretty good situation. I should try this. Stop. Sorry, Cecil, but it's not worth it for you. Maybe you could try curing yourself. It'll make you feel much better. What was up with that magic symbol that looked kind of broken? Wow, Cecil, you suck at magic a lot. I'm sorry to say that, but you do. Life to it is... I lost life too, didn't I? Oh, come on. It's going so well. Now, if only Edge could blink other people. Oh, come on. You took two turns in a row. That was blatant. Oh no, I already tried that. There we go, okay. Now I think we'll be fine. It really doesn't matter that much how much hit points they have, considering how frickin' hard this guy hits. Alright. There we go. Okay, so we're back up to about where we left off in terms of level. Half-Lunarian? Well, we're running long, so I think I'm gonna close it out here with the promise that next time we're going to confront Bahamut himself. Gonna be exciting. We're probably gonna get our asses whooped, but that's what we're going for, so in the near future, one can hope Odin and Bahamut. We're gonna take down the two big guys. I guess Leviathan is a big guy, but you know what I mean. So I hope to see you there.